This is a story of Kitty and Mimi and their friends and their encounter with the Dream Thief.
Oh, this is perfect! It's the perfect day to paint! I'm going to do great work today, I can tell!
School, Mimi was still depressed about her favorite dream's disappearance.
Mimi? Huh? Cheer up! Your dream will come back happy again someday.
Oh, maybe. But what if it doesn't?
Look at it this way, then. Maybe your dream got swept away because you've got a better one that's coming soon.
That'd be neat!
Attention! Attention, everyone! Did you hear? Did you? There's a really strange rumor going around all over town.
What kind of rumor?
Where'd you hear it?
Tell us, Fifi. What's the gossip?
You know, maybe I shouldn't tell. It's not nice to spread gossip.
Come on, you've got to.
Yes, Fifi. You can't tease us.
Tell us what you heard.
All right, if you insist. Apparently... Someone is sneaking around stealing dreams.
No way!
You can't steal dreams.
Who says?
How do you steal dreams?
I don't know any more than you do. But supposedly this creature eats the dreams.
What? You're just making this up, Fifi. There's no such thing.
I am not making it up. I'm just telling you what I heard.
But it sounds so ridiculous. You can't get into someone's dream because they're only in our heads.
Look, guys, you asked me to tell you, and now you're calling me a liar. I am not speaking anymore.
I believe you, Fifi. Can you tell me more?
Huh?
Who's doing it? And how does it get in there?
Oh, thank you. You're so sweet. I'm glad you believe me now. I don't want to seem like a liar. Mwah. I'm not sure it's true, but they say the dream thief goes in a dream and then gobbles up everything.
He gobbles it? The whole dream?
Yes, but he only goes into little kids' dreams that are happy. Especially the ones about growing up.
This still sounds made up.
Yeah, I'm not sure I believe it.
Let's not talk about it. It's scaring me.
On their way home from school that day, the girls were thinking about the dream thief.
Hold on, Mimi. Do you think that what Fifi told us is for real?
I've been thinking about it all day, and I think it might have happened.
But how can this thief get into people's dreams and eat them? them. You know, dreams are something inside your head that no one else is supposed to see.
I know, it's awful. It can't happen.
If there really is a dream thief, we've got to try and make him stop this.
How will we do that?
That's the hard part, but I haven't gotten there.
Sorry.
Oh, wait. I think I've got a plan. Come on, I need your help.
Oh. Kitty, tell me.
Okay, now I can tell you. Phoebe said that the dream thief sneaks into kids' dreams and eats them, right?
That sounds right.
So, if I have a really good dream, we'll be able to catch the thief.
I don't get it.
You'll see. Now, you better hide and keep watch.
What?
So when the thief comes to steal my dream, you can catch him.
Huh? Got it.
Are you ready, Mimi?
Yes, all set.
I want to play the piano. I want to play the piano. I want to play the piano like Mom when she was young.
Huh?
Do you see anybody yet, Mimi?
Uh-uh. Not yet. There's no one.
He probably knows. I must not have seemed sleepy enough.
That could be.
This could be hard.
Oh.
You didn't see him in your dream?
No, not that I know of.
Well, I'll try it again anyway. I play the piano. I play the piano. I play the piano. I am a concert pianist. I am great. Oh. Ah! It's too noisy around here. I'll never be able to fall asleep.
That evening, Kitty and Mimi asked their dad for some advice.
So, there's a dream thief, huh?
Have you heard of him?
Kind of. I've heard of someone who eats nightmares.
Really? Have you ever seen it?
No, but I think I have a book about it. Yes, here it is. It's a legend about Tappy, the nightmare eater.
Nightmare eater?
That's right. Look here.
He's really cute.
It says he eats bad dreams, but it doesn't say that he eats good dreams, too. In my dream, I was a really good painter, you see. It's my favorite dream.
It sounds nice. You've told me about that one before.
Now it's gone. But this Tappy wouldn't have eaten it, right, Dad?
Right. So that could mean that there really is a dream thief around.
Who do you think it could be?
I'm sorry, girls, but I don't know. I've only heard of Tappy the Nightmare Eater.
Oh, maybe this is all just something Fifi made up.
Mm-hmm.
That night, after the girls finally got to sleep, it was Kitty's turn to dream, and she finally got to be a great concert pianist. It was wonderful.
What? Ah!
Oh, good idea.
Only 5 more dreams to go until I'm big.
Huh?
My name's Puffin.
Hello, Puffin.
Are you related to Tappy the Nightmare Eater?
No, he retired. My family took over.
Well, it doesn't matter. But why are you stealing our dreams?
Oh, I'm not stealing your dreams. I'm eating them.
That's the same thing. You've come into our dreams of what we want to be later, and then you take them away and make us sad.
I know, and I'm only supposed to eat bad dreams, according to the rules of the Dream Patrol.
You mean you're not supposed to eat our good dreams?
But you are!
Let me explain. To grow up, I need to eat a total of 100 dreams.
So you're cheating.
Yep, but I've only got 5 more dreams to go, and now that I know what good dreams taste like, I can't give them up.
Well, can't you at least give us back the dreams you took from us lately?
No, I can't, because the dream won't count in my final score if I give it back after eating it, especially bad ones.
But they belong to us, you know.
And your keeping them is just like stealing.
They're just dreams. It's not as if they're for real.
Yes, they are, because they come from our own thoughts and feelings.
Now give them back.
Let's catch him, Mimi.
Right. Now we can go and eat other dreams, too.
We've got to warn everyone.
Kitty, why are you calling? It's really late now.
I know, but we just wanted to warn you, Thomas. We just saw the dream thief and he's on the loose.
Come on, you woke me up just for that? It's pretty late to be making prank phone calls, Kitty.
It's not a prank, Thomas. This is serious.
Kitty, you're just as bad as Fifi was this morning.
He hung up.
I can't believe she interrupted my dream for that. Huh? That's funny. A breeze must have blown it open. I just want to get back to my dream. The dream thief. He ate our dreams last night.
Oh. You all got your dreams stolen last night, too?
Everyone?
Uh-huh.
But we called you.
Yeah, but it's really hard to keep from dreaming on purpose.
And when you called, I was already in my favorite dream. I had to go back and finish it. Have no fear. Super Thomas is here.
Wow! What's yours, Jody?
In my dream, I'm a brilliant scientist, and I've just been awarded the Nobel Peace Prize.
And in my favorite dream, I'm a great baker, and I'm finishing a huge cake.
Oh, you are?
Oh, yes, but in this dream, the wind came and knocked it over before I could even taste it.
Huh?
course he did.
My dream was stolen too, and it makes me really angry. It's the first time I knew what I wanted to do when I grow up. I was a police officer.
You guys know the thief now, right? You all saw him.
That's right. He was this little fish who laughed a lot.
I would really like to know how he manages to get into our dreams.
I want my cake back.
We've got to stop this or we won't be able to have dreams anymore.
I know. I thought the same thing.
I love good dreams, so I'm just going to have to keep eating them.
I think this little guy plans to stick around for a while.
Not if I can help it.
I want my dreams back.
Down with the dream thief!
We'll stop him!
How do we find him?
The only time we see him is when he eats our dreams.
I've got it!
Huh?
I've got the perfect way to catch the thief! Everybody listen up! First, then we That's it!
All right! What a great idea, Kitty!
Thanks, Mimi!
When do we start?
I don't know.
How about now?
We could, but I think the thief must sleep during the day.
I know. After school's out. He must be close to waking up then.
I agree. But he won't be as alert as he is at nighttime.
Okay, that sounds great.
The rest of the day, everyone had to work extra hard to keep his concentration on the work in class.
Tyrannosaurus, the biggest and strongest of the meat-eating dinosaurs. He was 15 feet tall and had strong jaws full of sharp teeth.
I know dinosaurs are interesting, but this is math class, Kitty, remember?
Yes, sir. I'm sorry.
I'm getting nervous.
But we've put the perfect dinosaur in our dream, so it should work out.
Everyone's at his post, too.
Now all we have to do is lure the thief into our dream.
What if he realizes we've set a trap?
Shh! He won't, because I'll pretend it's a really good dream, like the others.
Well, be careful.
A little while later, they had trapped the thief just as planned.
You ate the dream, didn't you?
Now give us back all of the other ones, too.
Where's my superhero?
And my car.
And my Nobel Prize.
And my great cake.
Sorry, you're too late. This last dream was number 100, so I'm a grown-up. I don't have to listen to you. I can do whatever it is I please.
Let's stop him, go.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
From now on, I'm going to gobble up your best dreams.
But that means we'll just have scary nightmares.
That's not very nice of you at all.
I especially like the ones where you all grew up to do something you love. They're... Oh, I don't feel so good.
What's going on?
Oh.
Is he all right?
He probably has a stomachache or something.
From eating too much.
It serves him right.
He deserves it.
But he's really suffering. We should take him to the school nurse.
We'll take care of you. Don't worry.
I don't feel so good. I want my mommy.
So there you are, Puffin.
Mommy!
I've been looking all over for you. I was worried sick, son.
Oh, I have a stomachache, Mommy.
Because you've been eating all of these children's good dreams, right?
Yes, but now I have 100, so I can be grown up like you.
No, Puffin, it doesn't work that way. Our job is to gobble up the nightmares that scare children so that they can have happy dreams instead. It takes 100 bad dreams to become an adult, and that requires discipline and patience. If we only went around eating good dreams, all these children would ever have are bad dreams. Now, I want you to give their dreams back.
But how? They're swallowed.
I'll help you, dear. One more to go.
Are you okay now? Do you feel better?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I do, thanks. And those are yours. All of the dreams I ate.
Our dreams!
Yes. I'm sorry for all this trouble. It won't happen again.
That's good to know, Puffin.
We all forgive you, too.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Puffin, your dream is to be a grown-up someday, right?
And you want that to happen as fast as possible.
Uh-huh.
But we all know that dreams are something you have to work hard at to make come true. You can't take any shortcuts, son.
Oh, I know that now, thanks to all of you. Besides, who wants a stomachache? Not me.
Well, good luck. It was nice to meet you.
Come along now, Puffin. I'm going to give you some of that stomach medicine you like so much.
Oh, not the syrup, Mom. Please, anything but the syrup. Please, anything. Oh, I feel much better now already. Oh, you'll see. I'll be fine without it.
So bad after all.
No, just a bit impatient. Does anyone know how we get our dreams out of here now?
Huh?
My police dream.
My scientist!
My baker!
My superhero!
I can paint again!
I can play the piano! I can have my concert!
Thank you for the introduction, Kitty. Now, if you would please keep it down a bit, I would like to give my acceptance speech for the Nobel Prize.
Hey, Jody, be quiet. You're interrupting my favorite dream.
I was here first. You're the one who's interrupting me.
Have no fear. Super Thomas, the great defender of dreams, is here.
Come back and apologize, Thomas. Huh?
I have to give him a ticket for flying much too fast.
Huh?
Portrait of my cake? I'll let you.
No, I'm not painting your cake. I want to paint a picture of the river, Tracy, and your cake's blocking the view.
You wouldn't be able to paint it well enough anyway, Mimi.
Woohoo!
It's blocking the road!